بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, all praise are due to Him, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon all of His messengers, from Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, Muhammad. Brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, as Allah has blessed us to reach these wonderful days, the best days of the year, and we have been going over in different reminders on this platform with being able to remind ourselves of different types of actions that give us an opportunity to, alhamdulillah, get closer to Allah and maximize our reward with Allah in these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And I wanted to remind myself and those who are watching a statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, where he mentions something that is truly a gift from Allah. If we're able to receive this, it's an honor to have this gift from our Creator. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, "Min yuridillahu khayran yufaqqahu fid din." Whomever Allah wants good for, He gives him the understanding, the proper understanding of this way of life of ours. When we hear this hadith, brothers and sisters, subhanAllah, we hear from the Prophet, peace be upon him, that Allah is giving something to that person that is from all that is good. And we know that it's Allah that is wanting to give this gift to His servants. And that is the proper understanding of our faith. One of the biggest tests that we go through as new Muslims is we're given a lot of information. We're told a lot of advice. We're constantly being reminded of what to do or what to avoid. And we know that people mean well when they're giving us this advice. But also, we have to understand we came into Islam because we wanted to have that connection with our Creator. And we wanted to be able to go to Him directly and ask Him first and foremost for assistance and guidance and understanding, as He had guided us through our life up to the moment that we came to accept Islam. That Allah gave us some understanding, some awareness of what we were embarking on. Had we not known what we were going to get into, obviously we wouldn't have been open to even accept it. Why would I, as a human being who's able to do what I want to do, who is free to get things that I desire, what will be the reason that I would go into a system of living that restricts that freedom to do what I want? It was because Allah, even before Islam, gave us some fiqh, as the Prophet said here, yufaqqahu fid din. He gave us some understanding, proper clarity, in order for us to overlook our desires and be like, alhamdulillah. Allah is so merciful that He allowed us to overcome whatever were the barriers that were stopping us from accepting Islam, or remove things that went the message of Islam came to us, we were so open to listen to it. Because even before Islam, he gives people some fiqh of deen, some understanding. And even though some may look at it as basic understanding, well, alhamdulillah, that basic understanding is what saves us. By saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. I testify that there is nothing worthy of being worshipped other than Allah, and I testify that the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace be upon him, was his last messenger. For us to be able to receive that gift, alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, it's an honor from Allah to be able to gain that understanding. And then slowly we build within our lives the establishment of the prayer, the giving of the charity, the fasting in the month of Ramadan, and what we all hope to embark on one day, if we haven't already, is to go and make Hajj. Go to the pilgrimage to the house of Allah to visit it. And we know, as the Prophet ﷺ said, that when people go embark on to making Hajj, they're treated as a delegation of Allah. And that and those people, they accepted the invitation of Allah, and that Allah will answer their dua, their supplication. It's a great honor, alhamdulillah. That's what we strive for. So everything from the time we accept Islam until we are being buried, brothers and sisters, and even in our grave, what are the things that push away any type of difficulty? As the Prophet ﷺ said, is good deeds, the prayer, the fasting, reading Surah Al-Mulk, the 67th chapter of the Quran. These are things that protect us by Allah's permission. But where did that understanding come from? It came from Allah. He wanted good for His servants. So the more that we grow into our faith, the more understanding we get, inshallah, and we become more dependent on the Allah and independent from people's understanding. That doesn't mean that we don't have a connection with the people of knowledge or we don't have a connection with teachers. No, I'm not saying that. But we are human beings that are able to continue to grow so that when we sit with a teacher, that person is there to be a guidance, and so they're there to remind us. But the one that we return back to is Allah. So brothers and sisters, there's no greater gift than receiving the gift of the fiqh of deen, of the understanding of our faith. And we ask Allah, in these challenging times, with so much information being given to us, that we're constantly constantly receive the gift of being in an environment, being in a situation that we can gain understanding, proper understanding of our faith. And then when we get it by Allah's permission, that is one of those gifts that we want to appreciate and be thankful of and praise Allah in these great days. So that, inshallah, when other challenges come our way, that what we are basing our decisions, it always comes from the book of Allah, the Quran, and the Sunnah of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, his methodology, his way, his traditions, so that, as he said in his final sermons, in his final reminders to his people, one of them was that do not hold on to the Quran and his Sunnah. And if we do that, we will never go astray. But that it only comes with, again, Allah giving us this gift of proper understanding of faith. So whomever Allah wants good for, as the Prophet said, he gives him the fiqh of deen, the understanding of faith. And no matter what background you're from, no matter if you're non-Arab or Arab, no matter if you're a sister or a brother, young or old, whatever background you're from, it is Allah who chooses that. So no one can sit and tell us we're not able to be a person or persons that are able to understand this faith properly. It is from Allah. And that's who we return to. Brothers and sisters, may Allah Azza wa Jal make us of those who have proper understanding of our faith. Ameen. We ask Allah to guide us and to assist us to follow the way of the Prophet, peace be upon him, and that we're able to be of those who give proper invitation. When we invite people, that we do it properly for his sake. Ameen. And we ask Allah to allow us to be patient in whatever process that we go through and to make it easy for us. And that he blesses our families, those who have not accepted Islam with his deen. Ameen. And that he may preserve our families who are Muslim and preserve us and allow all of us to be in paradise. Ameen. Wa jazakum Allah khair. Wa subhanaka Allah bihamdik. Shadu an la ilaha illa ant. Wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.